Hallelujah, we glorify our God. May God be praised. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. We bless God for his word. We bless God for the mighty man of God. We bless God because of who he is. He deserves all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. Hallelujah. God should not have to beg for our worship. We worship him because he deserves it. Glory be to God for who he is. Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Hallelujah. Gracious and eternal Father, we honor you. We bless your holy name. We lift you up. We adore you because of who you are. We thank you, Lord, for your word, and we thank you for the man of God. We continue to bless your name for how you continue to use Pastor Randy to speak your word. Hallelujah, Lord, we bless you and we thank you. Lord God, we ask for your continued renewal upon him, that you will renew and refresh him, that you will continue to pour in this man of God, that he may deliver your word in Jesus' name effectively as he so does, Lord God. Hallelujah. I'm praying in Jesus' name that we as your people will take heed unto your word and that we will walk this word out because we want to please you. We want to please you because of who you are, not because of what you can do for us, but just because of who you are. Lord, the speaker said, even as we worship, we just praise and we worship you, Lord God. It changes our life. Change happens. Hallelujah. Because we worship you from our heart. Lord God, I pray in Jesus' name that you will continue to bless and keep Pastor Randy. Continue to bless and keep our covering pastor, the Reverend Dr. Maria Seaman. Thank you, Lord God, for our leaders. Thank you for how you continue to use them. Lord, may you touch them from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet. May you grant them the desires of their heart. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord God, because we know they seek you, Lord, not for themselves, but they seek you for us as your people because they yearn to see people saved. They yearn to see us push to another level. They yearn to see us walking in purpose and destiny. So I pray, God, that you will continue to refresh them, renew them, cover them. We pray a hedge of protection about them in the name of Jesus. And may you continue to use their mouths to speak, thus says the Lord. Bless and cover even their families. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us put our hands together. Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh my goodness. I want to go into praise. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. We invite our covering pastor. And as she comes, let us welcome. By putting our hands together in Jesus' name, because we appreciate this woman of God. We appreciate the wisdom, the words, and the instructions that comes out of her mouth. So let us put our hands to welcome our covering pastor in Jesus' name.
And more so, let's just continue to give God some praise right where you are. Hallelujah. God is, hallelujah. God, we give you praise. God, we give you worship. God, we thank you for who you are. Glory to God. We thank you that you indeed, God, have graced us with your glory, with your presence, with your Shekinah, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. How can you hear such a sermon and not just carry on some praise and carry on some, some worship and give God all glory and thank God that we know God and we know his word. And God knows us. How about that? Hallelujah. Wow. Wow. I don't know what to do with myself. A mighty message indeed, R.I.T. Fiery. Woo! Holy Ghost fire. Hallelujah. Transforming fire indeed. Hallelujah. I greet you, church, in the mighty, powerful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thanking God for who he is, God the Father, Son, and blessed Holy Spirit. Amen. The three in one, who he was, who he is, and who he shall ever be. Who he is in the beginning is who he is in the end. Hallelujah. Oh, I got to talk to you. I'm going to try to do this quick. Let me first of all say hi, Pastor Randy. God bless you, Pastor Randy Lightborn, and First Lady Reverend Eunice Lightborn, and the RITs, DIT. Well done. You're just like your covering pastor here, overseeing pastor. Get that baby in. Hallelujah. And God, we speak prayers and blessings over Dallas. Hallelujah. Hey, Shakande Arobose. Hallelujah. Amen. And even to the other little one, I forget her beautiful name, but Ashley's Sienna. There you go. Father God speaking in tongues right there. And we bless God for these women, babies who, if Jesus tarries, going to become women, women of God under the glory cloud. Hallelujah. And so certainly want to give an extra shout out to you, DIT. God bless you and strengthen you both as you recover and whatnot. Hallelujah. Well, first of all, I'm going to complain. Look at me smiling, complaining. I'm complaining. Listen, Beacons for Christ, and everybody's going to hear this. If the man didn't preach so well, I wouldn't have so much to say. So this next commentary is his fault. Jesus. But listen, let me tell you a story. Story, right? So this morning, I was listening to Bath Rafa. Me, I'm ambidextrous. I listen and think and all this type of stuff. And I heard God say something. I said, oh, I'm going to remember that. I'm going to remember that because that's powerful. And God was like, no, you're not. Write it down. So, and I ran to get it after your message. That's why I went off screen. He said, you're not going to remember it because it was powerful, right? So many things I've forgotten. But let me share with you before I go in my notes. I had to write it on this piece of paper, this envelope. Just wrote it. This is what he spoke to me in my spirit. He said, Maria, we of the year 2024, we have gone from the choir to the praise team to the worship leader. He said, do you know, Maria, this is a reflection of what went wrong in heaven. He said, we were in heaven with all the beings, and we went to the angels, and then we went to the worship leader, Lucifer. This is deep stuff. I'm going to have to do something with it. He said, where I wanted everything that had breath to praise, to worship, it became about one person. And then Pastor Randy, I know you keep up with things. This is where we have gone in churches now. The lights are dark, just the praise team and the band. And then, oh my goodness, the amount of singers who are now pastors, sometimes it's only about them. We want the pastor to sing because they're a superstar. I'm telling you, the danger when praise and worship is turned inwardly. And that's why the church, listen to me, because this is all this sermon. In the year 2024, we have mega means of showcasing churches with great praise and worship. Now they got dance music. It's Soul Train out there. You got all this. Well, wait a minute, Maria. But the church is as weak as can be. You know why? Because the praise is unto a person or its incarnality. And so if I had to sum it up in one sentence, which I'm not going to, but I'm going to tell you the sentence, it would be, we've gone from what we're doing today is a praise that we can do. Come on, say it again, Seaman. We're doing a praise that we can do. Who says this? Dr. David Jeremiah or this podcast girl that I like? Christianese. We know how to show up in church and clap hands. Oh, you could put the beat on. No different than 24th May Parade. Put a beat on. I have to watch out for it at Shekinah Worship Center, because that's praise, hear me, church, that we can do. I promise you, I had sinners in church today and they knew the beat. Last week too, they knew the beat. The difference is when you take your praise, offer it up to God, that it becomes worship, and now your praise is different. Hallelujah. Because your praise came out of worship. I'm through. It's a difference. When your praise, yes, in spirit and in truth, Reverend Doctor, when your praise comes out of worship, it don't matter what you go through. I have been since age 5, clearly, I can remember, thinking differently. Now, I have been through some experiences, folks. I won't go in them. I mean, devastating experiences. But I never lost my praise. I never lost my praise. I never lost my worship. I can remember, teenager, I'm 17 years old. No, because I came in from college. This doesn't even make no sense, but you're going to hear it. Yeah, this was earlier. Came in. Boyfriend picks me up at the airport. I won't say that part. Breaks up with me. I didn't cry in front of him, but I certainly went inside that cried. Listen to me. But that's a whole new... The boyfriend is the man I've been married to for 39 years next week. Because he found his right mind hours later. It's a story. 3-something in the morning calling me to say, can we get back together? I'm done crying. But that's because it was God ordained. But I tell you what, I've been in experiences prior to marriage, during marriage, which I am now. Whew. Some heavy blows, heavy, that if I was not a worshiper, I wouldn't have lasted. I would have become just a praiser. I know how to come into place and give me the good music. No, I am the music. That's what I just felt in my spirit. I am the music. Did you hear me? Hey, now I'm going to try to go quick through this, but I kind of summarized it, and I know I did, right? Your point one, well, first of all, why praise and worship God? Changes. It's no way you can worship God in spirit and in truth and every aspect of your life be changed. I did not say I'm going to win. I have lost. And I would ask God, I would say, God, I ain't done no sinning. I ain't never had sex before marriage. I ain't drank. I ain't smoke. I ain't cuss nobody off. I honor my mother and father. How could I be going through this? It's all right to complain. But you better get it together before the Lord's day, which I always did. Because I didn't know, church. I did not know God was building me up for what I'm doing today. I could lift some weights. I could be hated by all of Bermuda and it don't mean a thing to me. No, because I went through some stuff. I got my worship. See, when you leave your emotions at people, you worship them. Listen to me, be very clear, everybody. I ain't giving you that type of power over my praise or worship. Hurt my feelings. Do all that, but I guarantee you, I'm going to the front of the line. I'm going to worship. Come on, somebody. Come on. Hiya. Oh, Lord, Eunice, you done started something today. Hey, hiya. Hallelujah. And so, you know, I'm just going to mention your point one. You said, what type of worship God wants changes your whole life? Praise to worship. And then you come back to righteous praise. Everybody can praise. The worship leader said, everybody clap your hands. Everybody just praised. But when that praise becomes worship, now your praise, when she says everybody, you're already clapping your hands. It's a difference. It's a difference. Yeah. And so this worship is, look, this is beautiful. Worship is a submission to God. God, I submit. Yep. And then you dealt with Job, David, you were in the book of John, Jehoshaphat, all went through experiences. and they still worship God. And by the way, let me say this, because I'm just going to say it. These were Israelites. So I believe all preaching cards should be taken away from people who are not for Israel. Because these are the sermons we preach. It's about Israel. I will keep saying it. You know why? Because I believe the God of the Bible. And if he came through for his people in all these scriptures that I heard, he's going to come through again. I don't know how. I may not know how. I may not know when, but he'll do it again. Yes, he will. That's the God that I serve. And then, of course, you also talked about Hezekiah. I like this. This message was a fully loaded potato. It had everything, the bacon bits, the cream cheese. It has had everything in it. Butter. Then they added more butter. Anyway, Hezekiah, I loved this. He said, let's go back to the original worship. Forget all this modern stuff that's failing us. Hiya, can we go back? And you know, I experienced, is my sister still on? She must have been on. I experienced this a bit when she was preaching. Some people would think that, Allison, tell me, when you have that song at the end come out. She didn't, you know, but I felt the drawing. Go up there with your sister. Hey, oh Lord. She would have ran, I would have ran too. Took my flip-flops off and ran. I would have. Because praise, worship, it draws you to do something different. My God, do something different than you've ever done before. Your point two, why praise is so important to us. Psalms 42 and 11. Oh, my soul has been cast down. My feelings are hurt. My heart is broken. That's all your soul is, Ram. And disappointed. What's the answer? What's the response according to the Bible? Yet will I praise him. See, but you got to have it to do it. If you don't have it, even if you do it, God's not looking at the outward. He's looking at the inward to say, is this how they always do worship? Because I'm going to say this. We can't pimp God through a fake praise and worship. Come on, did I just say something there? Hallelujah. No. That's why he doesn't look at outward appearance. He goes straight to the heart. Do you have a heart of worship? Because church, this was something. Because if you have a heart of worship, you're always a worshiper. You don't show up as a worshiper on a special day. You are always a worshiper. I'm telling you. And then I'm winding down here. Oh, my goodness. In 2 Chronicles 20, 18 through 21, I think it was, no matter what army is coming after you, your response, church, praise and worship. And I sincerely appreciate this sermon because God was saying to me, that's how you got through, Maria. You're a female. People can't handle you. People stab you in the back. I'm sorry, people knife you in the front. And your church is still successful and your church will grow. Why, Maria? You worship me anyway. This and her. My praise just went up. Oh, we're going somewhere. And so two more statements. This statement here, put your robe on and get to the front and worship. Put your robe on, get to the front. Hallelujah. That's why at some point, maybe 2-3 years ago, Reverend Doctor, I said, I need my worshipers up front. I need you all to, don't worry about, I'm on TV. Don't worry about none of that. Get to the front. I need my front line worshipers. Come on, obey the general. That's right. It does something. Hallelujah. I preach to the front row, you know, I see everybody, but I'm preaching. In other words, when I say front row, it's not the literal, it's the figurative. If you're a front row worshiper, I'm looking at you saying, all right, let's keep it going. Hallelujah. And then the last thing, a very somber statement right here. And this is dealing with Hezekiah again, which I find interesting. That Hezekiah and the Levites had to fix what the fathers broke. Ha! They were told to go back to the words of David and Asaph. I think that's a heavy statement there, Pastor Randy. I pray that somebody in Bermuda hears it and really understand it. We cannot fix the murders. We cannot fix the stabbings. We cannot fix the profanity. We cannot fix the effeminate men. We cannot fix all of these things until the fathers go back to the word of God. And you say, fathers, you're so strong and big and don't need us females. You go back, get the words of David, get the words of Asaph, and repeat them in the ears, in the hearing of your children. When fathers go back, the females are right behind you. Go. Oh, yes, we are. I continue to say, I will be that prophetess Deborah. I will speak to say, come on, Barak. God wants to bless you, but you got to join the army. You got to lead the army. Now, let's go and let's do it. Pastor Randy, as you can tell, one more time, you have just blessed my heart, and I am always encouraged to just, I love God's word, fall in love with it over and over. Church family, I challenge you, listen to your man of God, the sermon 3 times a week, at least. Then you're going to grow, and you're going to recognize. Praise and worship, yeah, changes God to change me. He comes and he sees about me what I'm going through. That's what he'll do. God bless you, folks. Blessings abound.
Come on, everyone. Let's put our hands together for our covering pastor, Dr. Maria Seaman. Thank you, Pastor Seaman, for your timely nuggets. I have 2 nuggets on your nuggets. Put your robe on and get to the front. I loved that. That's me. I'm the front seat worshiper. I will embarrass myself for God. Hallelujah. Yes. And are you, I want to say, are you a front row worshiper? I love that. Yes. Amen. Amen. So thank you, Pastor Seaman, for those nuggets. Hallelujah. The commentary. Yes. So as we meditate on what has been said, let us sing. Let the church say, amen. Hallelujah.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church, say,
amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church, say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church,
to what his word says.
Let the church
say,
amen.
Amen. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Make this your response,
amen,
to whatever he said.
Amen.
From the healing of your body,
amen,
to the raising of the dead.
Amen.
No matter how you feel,
amen,
or how your world is real. You're gonna win the fight,
amen,
even in the valley,
amen,
or standing at your Red Sea,
amen,
continue to say,
amen,
cause your help is on the way,
amen.
Why God has spoken, I heard him, so let the church say,
amen.
Church
say, amen.
God has spoken.
God has spoken.
Hallelujah.
Let the church
say.
Hallelujah. Let the church say amen. So before we invite our brother Roger to come and say the closing prayer, we just want to, as Beacons for Christ, give our blessings and congratulations to Sister Ashley and Brother Johnny on their beautiful baby girl, Sienna. Hallelujah. And additional blessings and congratulations to our DIT, Lachey, and her husband, Desai. Congratulations on your beautiful daughter, Dallas. And we also want to not forget to wish our blessings and happy wedding bliss to our RIT, Laquita Otterbridge, and her husband, Brother George Otterbridge, on their 17th wedding anniversary. Hallelujah. May God continue to give you more years of happy bliss in Jesus' name. So we will now invite our Brother Roger to give us the closing prayer.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Wow, what an amazing service. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, what honor it is to be blessed to be in the house in such a powerful and amazing word. Father, I know this word has been designed to hit each and every one of us. Nobody is here by accident. Everyone that heard this word, Father, is here for a specific reason, and that is to take this to the next level, Father. And I am so grateful to be able to be blessed to be here, Father. I thank you for this entire service. It had anointing reading all over. It had your favor reading all over it, Father. And I felt so blessed to be here. And I thank you, Father. May it take each and every one who has heard this message to the place that it's been designed for it to take us to. Let us be diligent about it, Father. Let us take authority with what we know we've heard, because it's from you, Father. And I thank you. Once again, I thank our covering pastor, who continues to work in excellence, who continues to put an even deeper boost to the goodies that we're getting. We are so blessed. And I pray that as we all leave, we take these goodies with us and we move like we know it, because you are a great and mighty God. And we give all honor and praise to you. Continue, Father God, to cover these wonderful and mighty warriors of yours who are here today, Father. And all those who are going to be listening to this message at whatever time they do, it's a specific reason why they are hearing this message. And let us all move on it with full authority in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen, Brother Roger. Thank you for that powerful closing prayer. So let us, as we wrap it up, say the Beacons for Christ kingdom affirmation. Hold the line. We are Beacons for Christ. Off the beam shine. Battling against the spirits of darkness, we hold the line. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, we align anchored in his strength. We hold the line. Our branches will bear kingdom fruit. We are attached to the holy vine. We remain resolute in kingdom purpose. We hold the line. We take on the great commission to spread the gospel to all mankind, steadfast, unshaken, and kingdom assigned. We are beacons for Christ, and we hold the line. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just want to thank you for joining us here at Beacons for Christ UK. And we pray that you have received what our pastor said. His points were, praise is an expression of our faith and why God is due our praise and consecrate ourselves to him. And finally, praise God for his mercy endures forever. I pray that God go with you from this point, that you worship him in spirit and in truth, and that he build you up this week. Be a beacon for Christ. May your light so shine before all men that they would see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. In Jesus' name, amen.